Welcome to today's video. Today's video, I'm looking at the new Ford Mach-E. I'm going to give you all the details that you need to know about it. This is the new fully electric car from Ford. Ford are going to be selling this in two variants. They're going to be doing an all-wheel drive version and a rear-wheel drive version. It's going to be available with two battery specs. The batteries available are going to be 70 kilowatt hours and 90 kilowatt hours, but the actual total size of the battery is 75 and 99. If you go for the smaller 75 battery, the CCS charging port on here at the bottom will only charge 115, but if you go for the larger battery, it'll be capable of up to 150 kilowatts. Ford have partnered with Ionity, they're an Ionity partner network, and you'll get 1 year's free membership into the Ford Pass system for charging on Ionity network a little bit cheaper. The smaller battery will be able to do 280 mile range, and the larger battery is going to be capable of 370 mile range. So that is some real large range, Tesla beating territory from Ford. Ford Mach-E is going to start at £40,000. The first edition version of this is already completely sold out. This has been a really popular car from Ford. Now, you might ask why they've called it the Mustang, and I myself was wondering why an SUV from Ford is called Mustang, and the reason is, A, they wanted to show that Ford are properly going electric by putting one of their premium brand names on the car, but they've also made it sporty by having a much lower roof, like a traditional Mustang roof. So it's got a much lower roof. It supposedly drives fantastic. Now I'm really looking forward to when Ford might let me have a go on this car and actually see what it's like. The boot on this is fairly large. It's a 402 litre capacity boot with the seats up, and with the seats down, it's got a total capacity of 1,420 litres. So it's a really large, impressive boot. It's a huge, really big boot space. Ford have done very similar to Tesla. They put a large screen in here, but rather than the Model 3 where you've got a landscape, you've got a large portrait screen here. That screen here is an impressive 15.5 inches. They've also got a second screen in front of the driver, which is measuring a 10.2 inch screen in a landscape view. One thing that Ford have noticed is there's a bit of a gap in the SUV market for electric cars. There's not much affordable in. The most affordable one is the MG, but it's not got the luxurity of Ford, and it's not got the precedent of a Ford, and especially not of a Mustang. Ford have also made this capable of towing. It can tow 750 kilograms, which is a pretty decent, impressive towing rate from something this size and this weight. Damn. It's also capable of one pedal regen driving, which pretty much everyone wants, but you can also change it to just a standard automatic, so you're using both pedals. But if you want to use one pedal driving, Ford have also included this. What I really like about what Ford have done with this design is this lovely bonnet. You've got a crease down and another crease up and another crease down. It's rather than just a simple plain bonnet flat design, you've got lots of curvatures in it that really add to sort of the texture and the technique of the car. It just makes the car just look a little bit more stylish, and even these little cutouts in the light just make a more interesting design. Now, check with Ford, this front boot is waterproof. There's obviously a water seal here. Now, when Robert Llewellyn recorded a video on this on Fully Charged, he mentioned that there was drain holes at the bottom. That is waterproof, but the idea of the drain holes is so you could wash your dog in it, you could clean your boots in it, or you could put bags of ice in this one with beer. The other big one off Ford is what everyone wants to know: have they done the big one? Have they enabled over-the-air updates? And I'm happy to tell you, Ford have pre-thought this, and there is over-the-air updates on this car. I'd like to thank you very, very much for watching this week's video. Don't forget to go and give it a like. Don't forget to click subscribe down below, and don't forget to check out my other videos. Thank you very much, and I'll see you again next week. Goodbye.